How you doing? My name's Riley Beaver. I work for the U.S. Forest Service here in the Columbia River Gorge National Scenic Area. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the natural history and plants around the gorge here. So right now we're in the west end of the gorge here at Wahkeena Falls. And the area we're in right now is considered a temperate rainforest. The reason why it's a temperate rainforest is all the moisture we get from the Pacific Ocean. It comes all this way in the mountains, creating a rain shadow that draw a lot of the moisture out. Just a matter of 50 miles down the road, we go into an arid landscape, and that's because of the rain shadow too. So this gorge is one of the most drastic rain shadow examples you can see in the world. As I mentioned earlier, the Columbia River Gorge is a very wet climate. In this area alone, we can get up to 75 inches or more in rain a year. It's the middle of July, and we can still see the stream is flowing really hard right now. And you look around too, the vegetation is still green and lush, and it supports a lot of the native species we see around here. The temperate rainforest is a pretty rare forest around the world, so we're pretty lucky to have it here in the Pacific Northwest. Some of the dominant tree species you can see here in the gorge and the temperate rainforest here in the Pacific Northwest are the bigleaf maples, Douglas fir, western hemlock, western red cedar, and some vine maple. It's just some of the main dominant tree species, to name a few. Right here we have two examples. One right here is the vine maple. You can tell by its small leaves, and they grow with like 10 to like upwards more stems coming out, and they can grow thickets in the understory. Another tree right growing right next to it is the big leaf maple. You can just tell by it, it has a really big leaf. So for this part, I'm gonna talk about some common plants you're gonna find here in the understory. Here in the gorge, a very common plant we see is thimbleberry. Thimbleberry, you can tell, has very soft leaves. They produce a little red berry on them. You can see this is the stalk left from the berries earlier in the season. But they resemble a small, like, red raspberry. They're pretty good. And they grow in thickets all along the trails around here. And this is the red little berry it has. It resembles something that looks like a small raspberry. So here in the Columbia River Gorge, you're pretty much guaranteed anywhere here in the understory to find these plants right here. Some common ferns you're gonna find is the maiden here. One way to identify this one is they have a long black stem running down the middle, and they also have these spores underneath the leaves right there. And then right next to it is the sword fern. These ones are very really common too. They can get really big, and they have a bunch of spores underneath the leaves too. The reason why ferns like these are so common here in the Pacific Northwest is because of all the moisture we get from the coast. And also we have a lot of shade here in the understory too. Another unique and beautiful plant here you can find in the understory is ocean spray. The way you can find it or ID it is they have these really puffy white flower clusters, and they also have lobed leaves that are kind of soft. One thing that comes to mind when I think about the Pacific Northwest is the thick blankets of moss you can find all around here. So I'm gonna talk about another plant here in the Pacific Northwest you should be very, very careful of. This one is poison oak, and it's growing all along this hillside that we see right here. One way to identify it is like how shiny it is. It looks really glossy, it looks kind of fake. The leaves are low, but they can sometimes also be jagged. And another key identifier is that the leaves come in threes. See how all these leaves have three, have sets of three on them? And they can be a small shrubby plant, or they can turn into a vine too and climb up trees. So please don't go off trail. You know, going off trail, you risk being exposed to poison oak a lot more. So here in the Columbia River Gorge, we have a lot of beautiful and special flowers that grow here in the understory too. This plant, for example, is called fireweed. It comes from when fire comes through. As you can see, this log right here, the Eagle Creek fire was only about 2 or 3 years ago, and a lot of these wildflowers still grow and sprout every year. Another cool and unique plant you can find growing along the Columbia River Gorge is the foxglove. They have many different colors. This one's early in the bloom. And another fun fact about this plant, it's extremely poisonous. So don't eat it. So another common flower we can find around here is the red combine. The red combine has a few different types, but you can also find the purple one, which is really common. This is near the late end of its season blooming. It's usually one of the first ones to bloom in spring. And they're really common all along here in the Columbia River Gorge. Just want to say thank you guys again for tuning in, and I encourage you all to come to the Columbia River Gorge different times of the year and check out the local ecology and plants.